What was it like 70 years ago if you were coming into Chilliwack from the west? Well, really, there was nothing between places like Greendale and Chilliwack, or Sardis. Sardis was just a little town. Anyway, this is how it looked when you first would come into Chilliwack. And as you can see from how it looked 70 years ago on the right and how it looks now, things have changed considerably. But I think to get a better idea, let's go up about 8,000 feet and look down 50 years ago. And as you can see, there's a lot of changes there too, a lot of things different. Yale Road West is that diagonal road on the west side going from the top to the bottom, and as you can see to the west of that, there really isn't much more than a lot of fields that belong to farmers that were still a very, very agricultural. If you were going to go over to the east side of Yale Road West, just south of the tracks, you'd see P&E Building Supplies, which had been there since 1954 and across from what is now Corky's Pub. But for many of us, the memory of that area, the special memory, is the Dog and Suds, which was opened in the early 1960s. The Dog and Suds was an essential part of the driving circuit between the Derry-Loo and the A&W in those days. You had to stop and see who was there. This is how I thought it should look in a painting. This painting belongs to Russ Bailey now. Anyway, let's take one last look at the Dog and Suds, an iconic drive-in in Chilliwack cruising history. And then I'm going to take you back up one more time up in the air to just remind you again of how much things have changed. The Airport Road didn't go all the way through from Yonge to Yale West. There was no Rundle School, and Cherry Motors had just been built in that area fairly recently, because as recently as the 1950s, Cherry Motors was situated just on Yale Road West between Kip and Spadina, and across from where the United Church is, was and is. And so things had changed a lot. There were still these dealerships downtown. Cherry Motors had moved out to the Yale Road West area in the 50s. And also in the same area was a place that most of us remember, because most of us worked for them at one time or another, which was Fraservale. And Fraservale was a sprawling complex just south of Airport Road on the west side of Yale Road West. And like I say, most of us at one time or another moved irrigation pipes or picked berries or did something that involved Fraservale. Just one last look at what a difference there is now where Fraservale used to be. If you go to that same area now on Yale Road West, it's changed a lot. And that same area was also called Chinatown when I was a kid, because there was about 13 or 14 Chinese families that lived in the area. And it did suffer flooding in 1948, and that gives you an idea how it looked if you were near the university and you were looking southwest. That's how Chinatown looked in the flood. And this is Dorothy Kostreva, but she was Dorothy Chung in those days, and you can see the Chinese Masonic Hall in behind her there. And Wu Potato Farm was also in that area. And this is how it looks now in that same spot where she was standing. That must have been in the 1940s or the early 50s, judging by the age of the truck. We miss you, Dorothy, and we thank you for all you did for Chilliwack.